Hallelujah! Praise the Lord, children of Zion. You are all blessed in the name of Jesus. Happy weekend to you all. I don't know where you are watching me from. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. God bless you in the name of Jesus. It's me again, your friend, your sister, your girl, Holiness. May the Lord God Almighty bless you all in the name of Jesus. I want to use this opportunity to thank all my subscriber, my new subscriber, my old subscriber, those that are watching my video. I say, may the Lord God Almighty bless you all in the name of Jesus. If you have been watching my video, you have not subscribed, please don't do it because of me. Do it because of God. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. As you do so, God bless you in the name of Jesus. Children of Zion, God bless you all. If you know God have done a great thing in your life, I want to hear you shout a big hallelujah. Because seeing today, being alive today, is not by our mind, neither by our power, but by the Holy Spirit, says the Lord of hosts. May the Lord God Almighty bless you all. I want to hear someone shout a big hallelujah. Because being alive today is a great privilege. Our enemy does not want us to see today, but God make it possible for us. It's not that we are too holy, we are too righteous, we serve Him, we love Him. No, it's by His grace, it's by His mercy we are alive today. Someone shout hallelujah. Hallelujah to the King of Kings, to the Lord of all. May the Lord God Almighty bless you all in the name of Jesus. Before we start, let us pray a short prayer. Father everlasting, King of glory, we thank you, we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor. Thank you, O Lord, for making us to see today. If it's not you, we don't know where we could have been today. Some people love to see today, but they are no more. But you make it possible for us. Lord, we give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all adoration. I thank you, O Lord, because for the battle, for the great thing, for the wonderful thing, for a marvelous thing you have been doing in our life. Thank you, Jesus. Because if we have mouth all over our body, it's not enough to thank you. We come to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, for everything you have been doing, for things you will still do in our life. Lord Jesus, for this opportunity, we want to ask for mercy and forgiveness of sin. Forgive us our sin. Forgive us our iniquity. All our transgression, oh Lord, forgive us. All our past and present life, whatsoever we have done wrong, any sin we have committed, knowing and only. Forgive us our sin. Forgive us our iniquity. Cancel our name, the book of death. Write our name, the book of life. Give us power to sin no more. Come into our life afresh. Be our Lord. Be our personal Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for everything. Cover this prayer, every one of us, this video with the blood of Jesus. Father, you say you honor a word of your messenger. Daddy, honor my word in the name of Jesus. I cover my body, my soul with the blood of Jesus. Every spirit of distraction, mistake, I cancel it in my life in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for answering my prayer. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Children of Zion, you are blessed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, somebody. The last time we talked about as Abraham make a sacrifice to this King of Kings, to this Lord of all. This is part two of it. If you have not watched it, try and watch the video. This is part two of it. Hallelujah, somebody. We are going to open our Bible right now in the book of Genesis 22. Genesis 22, verse 17. Hallelujah, somebody. Genesis 22, verse 17. The Bible said, that in blessing I will bless thee, in multiplication I will multiply thy seed, as the star of heaven, and as the seed which is upon the sea. Hallelujah. And their seed shall possess the gate of their enemy. Hallelujah. You can see what the promise God promised Abraham. He said, in multiplication, I will multiply thy seed, and they shall possess the gate of their enemy. In meaning, all the blessing, all the things their enemy have, our God will take it from them. All the good things they have, he will take it from them and give it to Abraham. He said, in multiplication, I will multiply thy seed. In their generation, they will be blessed. Everything that Abraham have, their children, our God said he will bless them, he will multiply them. Hallelujah. It's good to obey the voice of God. It's good to obey the commandments of God. Because the way you do for God, that is the same way God will also do for you. Hallelujah. So I pray that we will have the appetite. I pray that God will give us the appetite to obey to his commandment, to obey to his word. I pray that we will not miss and we will not be a disobedient child to God in the name of Jesus. Because the way Abraham make a sacrifice to God, his only son, I don't know someone will do it on this earth. I don't think so. You will just hear a voice from heaven, from nowhere. Sacrifice your only son for me. We are talking about son. Most especially, those that have just one son. A voice from heaven will come. Madam, sir, sacrifice that only son for me. I don't think anyone can do it on this earth. But when Abraham heard that voice, because he feared God, because he loved God, he obeyed the voice. Later, angel from heaven said, Abraham, don't kill that child. Look round, look by your side. You will see a ram. Make it as a sacrifice to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, somebody. Because most of us, when that voice comes, sacrifice that son, your only son for me, you will ban that voice. In a thousand times, I bind you in Jesus' name, you demon. But Abraham, because he know God, because he fear God, Abraham obeyed that voice. He take his only son. He wanted to use it as a sacrifice. Angels of God from heaven say, Abraham, lay that knife on your son. Look beside you, you will see a ram. Immediately, Abraham turned. He see a ram. He used that ram as a sacrifice to God instead of his son. Why did Abraham did those things? Because Abraham loved God. Abraham, he feared God. That is why Abraham obeyed. It's not easy to do that. Most of us, God has speak for us in different way. Because of stinginess, we will obey that. We will disobey that voice. We will disobey God. Who is talking? Who is this? Demon, I bind you, I cast you. But we forget that God also speaks. There's different way God speaks to people. God can show you things in the dream. God can speak to you direct with a voice, through dream, through revelation, through vision. God can show you something. Most of us have passed those things before, but we will disobey God because of stinginess. Hallelujah. I pray that God will help us, because the sacrifice Abraham made for God, no man can do it in this our generation anymore. Because Abraham, he feared God, he loved God. Let's open our Bible. In the book, in the same verse, Genesis 22, verse 12, you will see it there. He said, lay not thy hand upon the limb, neither do thou anything unto him, for now I know that thou fearest God. Hallelujah. You can see it. Angel from heaven, He said, don't lay that knife on your son. I know you fear God. God bring a ram. He sent a ram from nowhere to Abraham to use it to sacrifice to God. Hallelujah. I pray that we will not miss our position in the way of God because of stinginess. I pray the position, the things, the blessing, the gift we have from God, that glory, that testimony we have from God, I pray because of ignorance, because of stinginess, we will not miss it in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will help us because all of us are looking for miracle. We are looking for blessing, but the things we supposed to do for God to bless us in a thousand ways, we are not doing it. I pray that God will help us because the one Abraham do for God, no one can do it. But my prayer is that God help us to obey your word, to obey your commandment, to obey your law. Hallelujah. I pray so that God will help us in the name of Jesus because we cannot do it alone. Someone who don't have a fear of God, you cannot do anything for God. You will just take it as nothing. No. But if you have the fear of God, if you have the zeal, if you have the appetite, if you have the wisdom, you can do something for God. Whatsoever God say do, you will do it. Things that we say don't do it, you will obey. That is the fear, the appetite, the zeal, the wisdom. I pray that God will use it to bless us. In anything he will tell us, we will obey in the name of Jesus. God bless you all in the name of Jesus. I cover every one of us with the blood of Jesus. I pray that we will not miss our position in the way of God. I pray that that blessing, things that God need for us because of stinginess and ignorance, I pray that we will not miss them in the name of Jesus. God bless you all in Jesus' name. I remain your sister, your friend, your girl, holiness. You are all blessed in Jesus' name. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.